As you see my insert in the beginning of this video, that is the town that I grew up in. And it is so crazy now that you got these crazy people like at Target or different places, refusing to wear a mask. Just imagine what it feels like to go to the laundromat and can't wash your clothes because you're not black, because you're not white. I'm sorry, because you are black and you're not white, and they have white-only laundromat. Okay, it wasn't only just a white-only laundromat. I remember going to the doctor and I couldn't understand. Even though I ran to the other side, there were two sides. Our side had, at the doctor's office, our side had like a wooden bench. It wasn't nice. It wasn't clean. It wasn't taken care of. She had one window in the window. She had a window on one side and a window on the other side to take care of us. But the other side was for white guests. I would always go over there. And they was like, "You can't go over there." I'm like, "Why not?" So I would go over there. They had the leather benches. They had magazines. It was nice over there, okay? And that was in my time, in the 80s, okay? In the 70s, okay? That was in my day. In my day. Not back in your grandmother's day, even though I could be a grandmother. I'm 53. So that is something I experienced, and a lot of us down south experienced. And a lot of city kids did not experience that, but they did experience the hate from the police that a lot of times keeps you in your neighborhood. If I'm 53 and I came and I was 18 years old and I had a car in Chicago and I drove through a Caucasian neighborhood, which I had no idea, it was just a neighborhood. And I just drove through there that night, just trying to think and just driving my own car legally. And I was body searched. Everything thrown out of my car, humiliated by a police officer late at night, and he tells me not to drive through that neighborhood again. Like don't drive through Schaumburg, Illinois. Because it was all white at that time. So the police would degrade you, make you feel a lot of fear in going into other neighborhoods. So think about it. A lot of black kids, were like me. They had children. And they stayed, on the south side. They stayed on the west side of Chicago. And they probably a lot of times told the kids, "Okay, don't try to go out there and get a job. Because I'm telling you what the white man gonna do to you. I don't want you to feel the way I felt. I got a job right now, I'm gonna take care of you." And that's a lot of times what happened in the late 80s when the people had children. A lot of them got jobs at the post office. Back in the old days, they had jobs at the steel mill. And they were so ridiculed and so hurt when they would just drive through a neighborhood and get degraded like that. But when you have children, you have to be the man, you have to be the woman, you have to be the mother, you have to be the father, and you have to put on a different face for your kids. Now we have the talk, about, going into these neighborhoods. If we allowed to have the talk. Back then, the talk most of the time was, "Don't go in the white folks' neighborhood. Don't go in the white folks' neighborhood to try to find a job. I know they're hiring, but don't go over there. They're not going to hire you anyway." So you drill this into their children. You drill this into your kids. But this right here has been institutionalized from all the places that they destroyed. As soon as black people tried to make it, like in Tulsa, Oklahoma, millionaires, they blew the place up, bombed it. Okay? And we're minding our own business, doing our own business, but we still get bombed and killed. Rosewood, Seneca, just name just few places. Think about all the sharecroppers. They hung in a tree because they had their own land. And they took the money in the bank that the black people made and saved up and took their money and gave it to the Irishmen that were indentured servants and turned around and let them buy our land that we worked on. If you really dig into history and see how the systemic racism ruined everything, brainwashed so many people, especially people hugging folks after they killed people in your family. You messed up. Yeah, really messed up. Okay. And a lot of things have ruined life, And I think that the pandemic is just God's way of saying, "Hold up, wait a minute. Somebody, y'all need to rethink life." The pandemic doesn't even make a lot of people rethink life. They're still shooting. They're still killing us. They're still killing. We're killing each other, but they kill each other too. Okay, it's just not as advertised as much as they advertise black on black. That's all. We both doing it. So what I'm saying is to say is the white only and mask only. Now you don't exactly know how we feel, though, because you can actually put the mask on, go into a facility or go into a store and buy something and walk back out the door. But as a black person in 1981, I could not go through the door, wash my clothes, and come back out. Do you understand that? Do you understand that? Because I couldn't take off my skin color and then go through the door. I couldn't put on a white, pale skin with no color and go through the door. I couldn't do that. You know, so I couldn't go in at all. At least you can put on a mask, put on a scarf, put on something, and go through the door and come back out. You can buy your things, go see the doctor, or go see a clinician, whatever you want to do, just put on your mask, go in, do what you have to do, and come back out. We could not do that. We couldn't even go in the building. And we could ask, why are we looking through the door? You know, so think about that. Think about that the next time you don't want to put on a mask to go into a building. Think about that the next time you feel that way. Okay, what if it said black only? If you're not black, you can't come in this door. Think about that.